everybody in the band has a different function, you know, like Danny is more the heart of the band, and, you know, Voody is the dad sort of thing. He's the leader, I would say.
And Bruce?
Bruce is the technician, and he's probably the best musician overall. And me and Tim are the ex-punk rockers.
What I'm trying to do is kind of add an element of rhythm that has never really been there before. Because, like, technically I'm not a very good drummer, but feel-wise, I can do it.
The structure of the music that we play is really different than a lot of other pop music, and it turns a lot of people off, and I think it turns a lot of people on as well. It's really modal. It's a trip being inside the music, because there's so many notes swirling around all at the same time that you really have to, it's more of like pushing large objects around than it is like doing surgery or anything like that. It's not terribly precise all the time. It's usually this sort of hulking mass that's sort of careening out of control. It's a lot of fun. It's also kind of terrifying sometimes as well. I could warm to any touch. So how did you get so cold? At first it didn't mean very much. Now you rule my life. I watch the house of cards. Take a deep breath. I watch it breathe word for word.
The new album, Mercury, that we're just finishing with Mitchell Froom is probably the best one we've ever done. We've gotten into Smokey Robinson and Marvin Gaye, so we're sort of listening to that kind of music a lot more than we are country western. So the album has a different tone and a different feel than most of our other ones. We tried to make this album a lot more aggressive because we felt that in the past we've made albums that were too soft, that were treating the music too preciously, which sounds like a good thing to do, except that you tend to lose the drive of the music when you're too reverent towards it.
It's, music just needs to have an edge to it, you know. It, not this overproduced, sheeny stuff. It's what I like about music. It's what I like about this band, you know, is that there's this underlying river of, you know, screwed up emotions running underneath, and, you know, perhaps without sounding pretentious, you know, music's a good way to bring that out of people and maybe help them a little bit. Well, it's never what you want. It's just the kind of thing that always happens here. Yeah, you watch the good old days pass you by, leaving your covers bare.
Every time I get interviewed, it always comes down to some kind of psychological study. Most interviewers want to know if they can possibly help me in any way, which is always kind of amusing. And I think a lot of people don't really see there's a lot of humor attached to what I do. I mean, you can always tell when people really have been through something, or when they have really felt something, because then their humor, there's humor attached. And that's, I don't know, I guess, you know, I'm trying to explain why there's so much humor in a band that has a reputation for being so intensely sad. I mean, I never thought that playing a sad song was about, you know, having some psychological problem. I think that only happened in the last few years. I think usually, when Billie Holiday sang, they never said that she had a psychological problem. Or when Hank Williams did a sad song, he never said he had a psychological problem. They said, oh yeah, I can relate to that song. What happens to the rat that stops running the maze? The doctors think it's dumb when it's just disappointed.
said that I would never see you again. But no matter how dumb I get, there's one thing I'll always do.
What we're trying to do is really approach music and approach our audience in a way that's as intense as it can be, as honest as it can be, and not trying to really pull the wool over anybody's eyes.
I mean, the music is, it's always, you know, tended towards folk roots. Even the first album, we played dulcimer, we played mandolin. There's lots of acoustic guitars. There's a complete acoustic number on that. And that came out in 1985, and here it is almost 1993. We've still got all the acoustic instruments. We've got the country western influence, we've got the pedal steel.
Because we've been together for so long, we've actually grown kind of close, and I sort of view the band as kind of an extended family. We sure work together well. We all know each other's weaknesses, and after 10 years, there's really never been any huge, serious disagreements. We're all equally as ambitious, and we're all equally committed to making our music, so it works out really well.